Hello, students. This year we are going to have some awesome communication lessons because I'm challenging you, my super duper capable fifth grade students, to be better communicators. We're going to have three activities this year to practice communicating. The first one that we're going to do, you're going to communicate with me and each other. The second one that we're going to do, the second activity, is going to be you communicating with other students in Granbury ISD. And the third is when we're going to actually communicate with others in the real world. The first challenge is going to be communicating with me and each other. My goal for you is that you fifth graders will think about science concepts and processes and methods that we have learned in our classroom. I want you to take those things that we've learned and think about them outside of the classroom. How are we going to do this? Over the weekend, we're going to take a picture or draw a picture of science that's happening around you. If you're able to, I want you to post that photo to your Instagram or Twitter or to our Google Classroom using the hashtag Pain5Science2016. If you're not able to post it, then bring a drawing to explain to the class on Monday. And over the weekend, I challenge you also to check your news feeds and comment on a classmate's photo. Let's think about and talk about science together. Okay, here are some cool examples of what I'm talking about. These are some pictures that I've posted to my Instagram. This is a picture of some flood damage that happened this summer, weathering, erosion, deposition happening around me. The next picture is a picture of a moon phase. This is a waxing crescent moon, lights on the right, it's getting bigger. That happened, took a picture of it, posted it on my Instagram. This is a really cool picture that Miss Kemper got, and she shared it with me, and it looks like to me that that's the day-night line, showing one rotation and one day, how it's changing from day to night. You can do it too. Just find some cool science stuff happening around you and post it or bring it to school on Monday. The second challenge is going to be communicating with other students in Granbury ISD. My goal for you on this challenge is going to help our fourth grade teacher friend explain how landforms are created to her students. She's running out of time. She doesn't have time to do the research. She wants you to help her out. So we're going to step in and help her and show her fourth grade students how landforms are created. Okay, how are we going to do this? Through a Google Hangout, we're going to develop a plan with that teacher on how we're going to explain them. We're going to research and build models together to present to our fourth grade friends. We're going to video all of our cool working models that we're going to create, and we're going to share those videos with our entire campus. So show everybody something that we're super proud of. The third and final challenge is going to be communicating with the real world. Okay, our goal today on that challenge is going to be to communicate with a photographer to discuss the importance of knowing about how light travels in their profession. So how are we going to do this? We're going to work together as a class to develop a slideshow and a screencast, just like this screencast, to explain to our photographer friend how everything that we've learned about how light travels, all the concepts that we've talked about. Then that photographer can reply back to us using Google Hangout or maybe another screencast like this to explain and show some examples of each of those concepts that's used in their profession. They can also share with us what happens if you don't know and understand these concepts. Okay, working together this year, we can and will be better communicators. We're going to let your voices be heard.